I'm Thomas van der Akker. I'm an obstetrician gynecologist here at the Leiden University Medical Center. My primary interest, both in the clinic and as well in research, is the maternal side of the pregnancy. I've always been intrigued by the differences in this world in terms of health outcomes and the healthcare that people receive. I think those differences are much too large. So that's why I left for Malawi, and that was a really interesting learning opportunity, but also sometimes a very frustrating time because you didn't have all the means available that you would have liked to have available. I remember some of the traffic accidents. I remember being called from the morning handover to find that a school bus with children had collapsed in front of the hospital, and I found 7 dead children in the emergency room, and several children that we still try to, you know, try to save, and in some cases we succeeded, in other cases we failed. Well, I think there are many things that we can learn from each other, and people are very innovative. Health professionals are very innovative. They know that there are several ways by which you can solve the problem. They are generally very able to rely on their physical examination, their hands and ears and eyes, which is a skill that we have sometimes lost here in a high-income setting, where it's very easy to do an ultrasound scan or a CT scan or whatever. So always think about what is best for this woman in this specific setting, and what can I do to really help her, rather than just following the protocol like we always do. Which is a recent publication in the Lancet Global Health has suggested that because of COVID-19, and particularly because of the measures to address COVID-19, maternal mortality is likely to go up, maybe up to 40% higher than before the pandemic. Child mortality is likely to go up, and that's probably because the access to good healthcare is going down. And that's a serious issue. Cardiology. Whew, films. Chaotic. Foreign country. Yes. What I think what we can do sometimes better in high-income countries is that we can focus more on the big problems in the world rather than on some of the high-tech problems in the high-income world. So for instance, in my field of obstetrics, I know that you have a lot of education on twin transfusion syndrome and fetal therapy, which are very important things, but mostly happen only here in Leiden. Whereas I think it is very important that you also know about fetal growth restriction and prematurity and all the big killers of babies in this world, for instance. So I believe we still have a task, you know, to make medical students reflect on what the priorities are in medicine. The importance of attending a conference for me would be meeting with people who share a common interest but are still very different from myself. Discussing with them, interacting with them, sharing thoughts together. I think that's really a valuable element, and even more so in this time of COVID. So I realize that the next LIMSC will be an online experience, but we need also those experiences really to connect, because if we don't connect, then we cannot make the world a better place. So unfortunately, it will now have to be online, but we all need it. And I encourage everybody to subscribe and take part in LIMSC. High-income countries and low- and middle-income countries, if they work together, they can really, in terms of research, they can really tackle the big problems of this time. So for instance, in high income countries, we often have the technology and the artificial intelligence to look into big data, whilst the big problems in terms of, for instance, child mortality and maternal mortality, the numbers are really in the low and the middle income countries. And if you combine, you know, the numbers from over there with the technological possibilities over here, I think that combination is really interesting and we can really make a difference. And in that sense, I think it's very important that researchers from different countries really collaborate in larger networks. And in those networks, everybody contributes. And I really believe that together we can make the world a better place. We can really best, and like we know what people over there should do. That's not the beginning of a solution at all. We really need to collaborate and use each other's strengths. Well, first advice I always give to students who come because they're interested in doing a scientific internship, for instance, the first advice I always give is follow your heart and choose a subject and a field of medicine that you're passionate about, that you really like. Don't go into something because me or some other professor tells you that something is good for you. It should feel good to you yourself, and you are the one who should take your decisions. And if that means going to another place than the Netherlands for a period of time, that's good. If it feels good to you to stay in the Netherlands and become a neurosurgeon, then that's also good. Listen to your heart and follow your passion.